Welcome back. Today I had just received my Orion Micro Welder, a new model, with the upgrade of the larger and magnified ADL, which is Auto Darkening Lens. So I'm going to unbox it and show you how to assemble, how easy it is, and then I'm going to do a full discussion and review of it compared to my existing Orion mPulse, which I love and I've been using for a number of years. I hope you will find this interesting. Okay, I want to open this up and set it up for you. I'm really happy with the purchase. This is the Orion mPulse with the upgraded ADL, which is Auto Darkening Lens. And it's packed like this with a full guide. It's excellent. This is the power cord. And this is the mount. Okay. Some new version. Pieces over there. So this is the box with the electrode. And this is the beautiful lens that makes it a lot bigger than the other version. It's my first time setting it up as well. I like it that it is carefully packaged. I'm gonna take that out. Okay. Oh, this is gorgeous. Look at this. This is much bigger. And it swivels like this. Okay. Okay, it's just perfectly tight. Okay. All right. So that wasn't difficult. So, there are lots of places where you can tighten and pivot until you are comfortable. And then the electrode. Oh, I like this. They've got this protector. I just have to get this off. So, got this off. This part goes here. You can slide it whichever way, you know, if you want to do that. This pivot so that we can hold like this, how we want that. So we have this cord, and I know this cord looks familiar because it is one that connects the screen to the power the box. So what we have here comes with the brush. So you have the power cord, and this is the adapter. So this cord goes here. This is the adapter. This gets plugged into here. Okay. This, I'm not gonna use this right now. That's for the argon gas. And the argon gas tube gets plugged in here for the gas. This here is for this. For the screen and the electrode, and just plug in here on one side. Here it is. This is a newer version. I love it. Ta-da! So now this, I'm gonna go to the power. Okay, so I've plugged it in, and you'll see that the power has gone green, and then switch it on, voila! Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm gonna leave the protector on. So this is to increase power, decrease. I like to weld most of my jump rings at 7 watts. I find that works the best. Anyway, I'm a little ahead of ourselves because I'm so excited. I don't need to really look into setting the power right this moment. Oh, I like this. So there are two that you could use. One's an alligator clip and another one that you could clip onto that's a little bit smaller. So This would be really good if you were clipping onto a pair of pliers. This would be very good for something smaller like a jump ring or a chain. So I'm just gonna use this. This is the grounding clip. And this is the power, and I plug it onto the top, like this. Okay? Because without this, it will not work. Now, we're gonna put in the electrode. So this is the stylus. It comes with this package. You really don't need a whole lot. This will last you a long, long time. So this is the tungsten electrode. And what you do is you snap this open, just push. It's not a turny thing. Take it open. Gosh, I've forgotten what the name is. It's like a grommet. So then you put this in like such. But what I do is I know this goes in here, this notch right here. So I want it to stick out, yeah, around that much. So I do this, turn it. I turn it clockwise, it tightens this. And if you want it untightened, just do that. And you can try it out to see if it goes. So that's your sharpened electrode, like this. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is now move the camera so that you can see through here. And then we're gonna weld something and then compare it to this, the old version, the old model that I have. So there is this piece at the bottom, and I didn't put it on because I have to take this apart as well. But what you can do is once you've figured it out, you put it in, you screw that, and that's a finishing piece. Looks beautiful. Okay, so this is what it looks like. So that's the electrode. This is a magnified screen. So this here says 7 watts. I love this. You can rotate like this to make it smaller or bigger. And I like I was saying, I like 7 watts for most jump rings. And then you can go step up or down. You can lock it, so in case you don't, if you touch it by accident, it doesn't go to 30 and without you knowing. And then that is the on button so that you can weld. We're all set. I've got some jump rings. First, I want to make sure that the jump rings are closed properly so that they meet properly. So then I'm going to clip the ground, and I think I've got this turned on. I like the magnifying. Okay, not sure if you can see this clearly. So that's what it looks like. Use the fiberglass so it gets rid of the fire scale. And don't worry if you don't get it all, because when you are wearing, so this is sterling silver, over time, it just comes off. So don't worry too much about it. But what we're going to do now is we're going to test, make sure that this doesn't snap off. That's very good. Look at, I've twisted it. I'm not sure you can see. I've twisted it. It's all mangled and it did not break. So now I'm going to compare for you. I really like this. There's pivoting. I like this, how big it is. And I'm going to now compare this with the existing base model that is not upgraded. So this is a screen difference, and I'm gonna plug this in. Okay, so I'm going to now compare apples to apples. This is the same model of Orion mPulse 30 versus my older version. Let me see if you can see this. The screen is quite a bit bigger. I'd say it's at least twice the size. And this pivots so that you can see better, or if the person's hand or in a certain position. This is a little bit limited, but still works very well. I love mine. So I'm gonna turn this on. Okay, all right, this is dirty because I use it all the time. And I'm gonna say this reflects a lot more because of the position of the lights that I can't change. Whereas this, because the lights are here on the panel, I can switch. So I like that a lot more. Yes, there is magnifying. Now, it's 5 times, but I would say that really I'm not seeing the magnifying as much as 5 times that I would with my magnifying glass. However, I do, because it's bigger and there is magnification, I see my finger. See if you can, yeah. So you could see that there is magnification. Even from here, you can see that it is slightly bigger. This goes in, it's limited as to how far it can go in. This goes in a lot farther. You have more room. And this costs $200 more, and I think you can still buy it to attach to your old, older model. I think it's well worth it. I wasn't sure whether or not it was worth the extra cost, and you know how frugal I am. But I really like this. It is very sturdy. It's adjustable to height. And I do like that it has so much clearance even for the anklet. This, I found that it was very difficult if I ever wanted to do anklets. But for both of them, you can just take it out and weld that way. From the weld, both of them are really very good. So I have no complaints. I think the conclusion is that I think it's well worth the $200 extra US. I hope you found that useful. I'm a wholesaler of premium quality chains and findings. I'm going to put a little bit more information about our company below, as well as more information on the Orion Micro Welder.